Hi, Mark Berman in the Roanoke Times here in Virginia. Based on who you've played this year and who you've beaten this year at a conference, I take it you probably, what's going to be the mindset for this team? I take it you probably won't be too intimidated playing a number one seed based on who you've played this year already.
Start with Maya.
Yeah, I think we like to embrace these challenges, and we're kind of excited for the opportunity. We know it's going to be obviously a tough opponent and a really fun environment. They're going to have a lot of fans, and so we're just really going to try to embrace that and just make the most of the opportunity. But we're excited about it.
How about Paige then, Kallie?
Yeah, you know, for sure. That's kind of why we play the non-conference that we do, to kind of get us ready for these moments. So like Maya said, we're just going to embrace the moment and are excited for the challenge.
Yeah, as they both said, obviously our non-conference really prepares us for moments like this. And I think we're just excited for the challenge and excited to have this moment.
Mark in the second row.
Mark Overhook, Dakota News Now. How do you guys feel today? That was a bloodbath. I hate to call a basketball game a bloodbath, but that was a physical, physical game. So how quickly do you recover from something like that?
Stay with Kallie.
Yeah, obviously feeling a little sore. It was a hard-fought game, but I think we're excited for tomorrow, recover today a little bit, and we'll be ready to go tomorrow.
Yeah, for sure. It's obviously nice we have today to kind of recover and get ourselves ready for tomorrow.
Yeah, we feel a lot better after a win, I think. But yeah, like they said, we'll take today to recover, and we'll be ready for the challenge tomorrow.
Okay. Let's come over here.
Ladies, in the postseason, you know, a lot is made of the home court advantage that you guys have at the Summit League tournament. Tomorrow you're kind of going to be walking into the opposite thing. What can you say about just the approach of going into that sort of hornet's nest?
Yeah, we've kind of talked. We're excited. We're kind of excited to be, you know, on the other side of that. And it's always fun when you get to play in an environment where there's a lot of people, a lot of fans. And we saw yesterday just the support that this program has. And so anytime you get to be a part of an atmosphere like that's exciting. And so that's something that we've kind of talked about, just embracing and having fun with.
How about Paige then, Kallie?
Yeah, you know, for sure. Like Maya said, we're just kind of excited to be able to be in this fun atmosphere and grateful for the opportunity.
Yeah, for sure. Obviously, there's going to be a lot of people there, and that's super exciting. It's great for women's basketball to have a crowd like that. So I think we're just looking at it as an awesome opportunity.
Let's second row and then David here.
Kallie, going into the USC game with their size, did you feel like you were going to play a big role? And then going into Virginia Tech, you know, how much do you think your size will kind of help you guys?
Yeah, I'm ready to step into any opportunity I'm given. I think definitely defensively, that's something I take pride in. So I was excited for that, and I'm excited for that for Sunday, too.
Hi, guys. David Cunningham, Tech Sideline. You and Virginia Tech, you are two of eight teams in the country that have a win streak of 10-plus games. What has helped you guys sustain success for so long this season through the ups and downs? And when you look at Virginia Tech, do you see any kind of similarities between how they've been able to sustain success lately?
Stay with Kallie.
Yeah, I think we've been able to sustain it just because we're a really close-knit team and we really play for each other. And I think that helps you get through any ups and downs throughout the season. So I guess don't necessarily know exactly what Virginia Tech for their success. But for us, I think it's just that we're a really close-knit team.
What Paige and then Maya?
Yeah, for sure. You know, just staying together and kind of taking it one game, one day at a time.
Yeah, kind of like Paige touched on, I think we've just found ways to get better throughout the year and found ways to get wins, but even in the wins, learning from them and finding ways to continue to get better as the season's gone on.
I want to go back to last night. It didn't start off very well. You guys didn't score for like 7 minutes, at least a basket anyway. How did you keep your positive mindset going? And then what was it like to watch your senior friend right there just say, just give me the ball, we're going to win?
Yeah, obviously we have a ton of confidence in Maya. She can take over a game, and she's done that plenty of times throughout her career and through this year. So it's awesome to see her do that. And I think that we knew it was going to be a game of ups and downs. So obviously it didn't start the way we wanted, but we knew we could come back, and we were able to do that and then sustain it throughout the game.
Yeah, for sure. It's obviously always fun to see someone on the team go off like that, especially Maya. You know, that gives a lot of more confidence to everyone on the team when, you know, Maya's seen shots going. So, yeah, it's just a lot of fun to see Maya do what we all know she can do.
How about Mark in the front row here?
Looking back, when you've beaten a team like Louisville or Kansas State or Mississippi State or even USC last night, what do you kind of want to bottle from those wins that helped you beat those kind of teams that you want to maybe duplicate tomorrow?
Yeah, I think just you know, the respect and the preparation that goes into playing such good competition, and so I think that's something that we really embrace, and just kind of that level of intensity that you have to match when you're playing a good team. And so I think having those opportunities in the non-conference are really good for us to kind of learn from, and that's something that we'll definitely draw on tomorrow.
We'll take a Zoom question here. I believe this is Hank Kurtz from the Associated Press, and I'll allow Hank to talk now.
Hey, Maya, you scored almost as many points in the first round as Chattanooga scored against Virginia Tech. What have you seen and what you've seen from them that's going to make that more challenging?
Yeah, they're just a really solid defensive team. They guard you really well one-on-one. And so I think we're just going to have to continue to do what we've done best throughout the year of just finding the open player. You know, we're so unselfish, and we can, any one of us can make shots when we have them. And so just really relying on each other will be important. But yeah, they're a really good defensive team, and we'll have to be able to match that.
Any follow-up, Hank?
How do you guys approach being visitors in a place that's going to be loud and against you?
Yeah, we're just excited about it. You know, anytime you play in an atmosphere that's, you know, has a lot of fans, good attendance is great for women's basketball. And we're just kind of in that mindset of we're happy to be a part of that. We, you know, we're blessed with great fans back at home. And so we kind of know what it's like to be a part of high intensity games. And so we just kind of like to be a part of big games with you know, a lot of support, and so we're excited about that, and we'll embrace the challenge.
Thanks, Hank.
Does it feel like you guys come out of nowhere, like South Dakota? Like, a lot of people don't even, like, know where that is, right? And, you know, South Dakota last year did well in the tournament. Does it – how cool is it to be, like, this unknown quantity?
Let's go with Paige and then Kallie on that answer.
Yeah, you know, we're excited to just kind of play against this kind of competition and show, I guess, everyone what South Dakota is made of.
Yeah, I think it's awesome to put South Dakota on the map, and I think it's fun to kind of be the underdog and to have that challenge, so I think we're excited for it.
Thanks, Hank. Let's go to Ian in the back row. Mark.
Hi, guys. Ian Sachs, Kellan Sports. This one's for Kallie. Last night, Coach spoke about the important role that you played in the game last night, giving some very big minutes. What was your mindset going into playing on the biggest stage and against such a physical team such as USC, and now having another physical team in Virginia Tech?
Yeah, I was excited for it. I think I like to play physically too, so I think that worked to my advantage. But they're obviously a great team. I knew that they have great post players, so it was going to be a challenge. But I think just stepping up in those moments and on the biggest stage is exciting.
Mark and then Mark.
Yeah, when you guys when you look at some of your Summit League scores, you put up a lot of points. But you know, last night's game and I guess the Louisville game, you know, are examples that you don't have to play that way, you know, to win. What is it about this team? I guess do you kind of feel like, you know, whatever the style of play is, whatever the tempo of the game is, you can win that way. What's kind of you know, the approach, being able to win in different styles?
But Maya, go ahead.
Yeah, I think, you know, we've had games this year where we've scored a lot of points, but in those games, our first priority is always defense. And so our defense leads us to offense a lot of times, but when our offense isn't going, our defense is really what we kind of pride ourselves in. And so we try to, you know, rely on our defense. So then when, you know, nights are like last night where offense was harder to come by, we can still kind of rely on our defense.
Mark, go ahead.
You stole my question, Mark, so I got to come up with something else. 45 points in regulation, then bang, you turned it on in overtime, scored 17 points. Do you feel like that momentum is going to carry over into the game tomorrow? Because obviously you got to shoot better to beat Virginia Tech.
Yeah, I think hopefully, like I said, we obviously pride ourselves defensively. So I think when we can get stops and kind of get us going offensively, that will be good. But yeah, I think we ride the momentum from, you know, an exciting game and an exciting finish. And yeah, part of it's just first round for new environment. So hopefully we can kind of shake some of that stuff off too Sunday. But either way, we're excited and we'll be ready to go.
How about Paige?
Yeah, like Maya touched on, we're just take a lot of pride in our defense. And, you know, yesterday too, we were getting good looks and they just weren't all falling right away. So, you know, just keep being confident and shooting that shot when you're open will definitely help.
Mark, are you good? Okay. One more from Mark here, and then we're going to take a Zoom question from Hank.
Yeah, to follow up on your defense, what did you like about your defense last night that maybe you want to replicate tomorrow, you know, in terms of how you made it a tough shooting night for USC?
I thought we overall, both our guards and our posts, did a great job just contesting shots and making it tough. We really prepare well, I think, in scout. Our coaches prepare us well to know where we want shots coming from. And so I think we just did a good job of forcing tough shots.
So you guys are not a Power Five. USC is. How much does it mean to you guys to knock somebody like that off?
We'll start with Maya.
Yeah, I think, you know, we kind of pride ourselves of being mid-major student athletes, and we're proud of that. And so I think anytime we have the opportunity to represent, you know, the Summit League, SDSU, against Power Five schools, we're excited about that opportunity. And just to see how this program's continued to grow is exciting for us. And I know we're always just grateful to be a part of that. And we want to represent, you know, SDSU and mid-major as well.
We'll do Paige and then Kallie.
Yeah, for sure. We're always just really excited to, you know, step up to these kind of challenges that we're given, you know, throughout the year. And like Maya said, just represent the mid-majors as best as we can.
Yeah, obviously USC is a great program. So to be able to win yesterday was great. But I think we're even more just excited to earn another opportunity to play on Sunday.
Can you guys win a shootout with Virginia Tech?
Sorry, I didn't.
Can you repeat that, please, Hank?
I said, can you guys win a shootout with Virginia Tech?
Yeah, I think obviously, like we've kind of touched on, we pride ourselves on defense. And so that'll definitely be our priority going into the game. But I mean, I'm confident in everyone on our team to step up and make big shots. And so we'll see how the game turns out. But yeah, I'm confident in everyone that we put on the floor.
Last two, we'll go Angel in the back and then Mitchell.
Angel Gray, ESPN, just a question, even going off the Power Five, not just with the conference, but for your team specifically, it's like you have a Power 10. You guys come in waves. So when you're looking at how beneficial that is for you, especially coming off of a year where you have that postseason experience of what it takes to win each game, how beneficial is that for you, knowing what it takes to advance each level in the NCAA tournament?
Start with you, Maya.
Yeah, I think, you know, we have a lot of experienced players on our roster, and we had a lot of good experience last year just going through a postseason run, and how, you know, postseason games are different, every game matters. And so just to have that experience is really important. I think we can kind of lean on each other, and you know, we've been here before, and trust each other in that. And you know, our freshmen and new players have stepped up great and have just filled in, but just having that experience, I think, just allows us to trust each other when you know, those big moments come.
Paige.
Yeah, for sure. You know, we're always there for each other, and just, you know, having those veterans that have been through these experiences just helps, like, the younger players, you know, get through these opportunities. So, yeah, definitely just the experience helps.
Never count.
Yeah, we have a lot of experience on this team, as they both hit on. Obviously, our last year WNIT run definitely prepared us for this moment. But I think we had earlier games and non-conference, too, that definitely prepared us. So I think we're ready for it.
Mitchell, go ahead.
Yeah, this is for Maya, Metro Northern, before the win. If I'm looking at your stats right, this is your sixth season of college basketball. So I'm just kind of curious, you know, from your perspective, when you first got to South Dakota State, how was kind of, you talked about the confidence you all have against Power Five teams. Has that changed at all since you've been there? Has that grown, and kind of how has the program sort of evolved since you've been a part of it?
Yeah, well, you know, I was lucky enough to come in at a time where the program was really on the rise, and played in some really, really good teams my first couple years. And so it was fun to be a part of that, and just being a part of this program has really, I don't know, made me appreciate just what we have building here, and just grateful to be a part of it, because I think just every year we just find ways to continue to grow as a program. And when you see that success and you get to taste a little of that success, you know, you just build that confidence in each other and in the program and the system and, you know, the culture that we've been creating for a lot of years now. So I think, just as I reflect, it's just, I'm grateful to be a part of a program like that.